Hi! Today I'll be sharing with you the documents you need for your cabin crew interview or when you're going for your training. So number one is your passport. You can apply even if you don't have your passport, but once your interview is done, you will eventually need your passport. So that's the most important mandatory document that you need. And do not worry about whether you'll fly international or domestic. You need your passport, so just get it done. And number two is your Aadhaar card. So if you don't have your passport on the day of your interview, you can give your Aadhaar card and they will ask for it. So you can tell them that you don't have your passport yet and you want to just give your Aadhaar card for the time being. They will consider it. But other than that, also individually, separately, you will require your Aadhaar card, so make sure you have it. Number three is your PAN card. Now, all these documents that I am naming, you will need the original ones, but you will also need to submit photocopies, hard copy as well as soft copies. So when you create a profile on their website, that you will have to when you register yourself in their website for the interview, that's when there are options for you to fill in your details, and you will have options of filling in all the documents that you will eventually need. So your passport is there, your Aadhaar is there, your PAN is there. So you have to have all the documents, soft copies on your phone. You can scan them and keep it. And you will also need the hard copies on the day of your interview. It's better to carry. You will not need all of them on the day of your interview. But once you are hired, you will need them once you're going for your training, or maybe once you have reached the training center, once your training has begun. And on the day of your induction, that's when they do most of the documentation. So you will have to submit a lot of documents and a lot of proofs. And it's better to keep like multiple copies. I will tell you how many. But moving on to number 4 and number 5. These documents are your 10th grade sheet and your 12th grade sheet. Now, your minimum qualification to be a crew is 10 plus 2. So you will need both your 10th and 12th mark sheets. And if you have graduation, this is your number 6, document number 6. If you have done your graduation, or you have done your post-graduation, or you have diploma or any other degree, you can take a copy of your degree. Now, number 7 is your postcard size photo. You will need a lot of pictures, and postcard size is one of them. So if you don't know what postcard size is, it's the normal photograph size that you get for, you see in your family albums. It's roughly around this much. And how or what picture you will take, I'll tell you that. You have to be in a formal attire and you have to have proper hair, proper makeup, and it should be visible head to toe. And make sure that your hairstyle is such that your ears are visible, okay? Your ears should be visible. Now, if you have really short hair, you can keep it open, but make sure your ears are visible. And if you have long enough to make it a pony, make it a pony. If you can make a bun, excellent. And this is not just for the picture, it is definitely for the day of the interview as well. You can, the neater you can go with your hair, the better. And makeup, please do proper makeup. If you don't know how to do too much makeup, it's okay. Just put liner, just put like a nice red lipstick, wear pearls for your ears, and you're good to go. If you have any marks, try to conceal it. And that's it. So you need 2 copies of postcard size photos. Now, they might or might not ask for it, but it's safer to have some. Now, like I said earlier, that you will need photocopies of every document. They will tell you that you need 2 copies. Okay, they'll email you or they'll ask that please bring 2 copies. But trust me, please carry 5, 6 or even 10 copies, because you will need all of them all the time. I don't know, like they tell you 2 but they ask for 20. So the best thing you can do is carry as many as you can. But again, you don't need 10 copies, to be honest. You can just carry 4 or 6, 5, 5 copies of your passport, of your Aadhaar, of your PAN, or whatever documents, your mark sheets. So it's easier that way. You don't have to run around. But just to be safe and to, you know, avoid hassle, it's better you carry a couple of copies of every document along with the original documents. And back to postcards. Postcard size images you will need two, and you will need passport size images in your formal. Again, multiple, get 10 or 15. Okay, you will need a lot of passport size images, and you might also need visa type image, that is, you know, 70% focus on your face, your ears visible, and no hair on your forehead. So if you have fringes, let's say you have fringe cut, so you have to remove your fringes and you have to show your face, it should be completely visible. So visa type photo, but you can you know, avoid that for the time being. You can get it done when they ask you to get it done. Now number 9 is your vaccine, your COVID vaccine. If you're not vaccinated yet, please go get it. I am very sure that you will find the vaccine in some private healthcare place or some hospital, if not in the government places. So if you have one dose or no doses, please go get it. You don't need the booster shot, which was the third one. That's not mandatory, but the first two doses, it is the first and the second doses, it is mandatory. You will need it, so please get it. And again, I don't think you will have the original one, so it has to be a photocopy where your both doses and the dates are written. So make sure you have that. Now the next one that you need is your CV. Very important. You will need it on the day of the interview itself. You will probably not need it afterwards, so you don't have to get multiple copies, but it's better to have two or three. And make sure your CV is clear and nice. Make sure you have your photo on the CV, your name, your address, your contact, your email, your correct email ID. You know, you will be signing up from your email ID in their website, so make sure you put that particular email ID. Don't lie on your CV, just make a simple one. Don't put colors, it does not help. Keep it simple and you're good to go with that. The next few documents are for your salary account that you have to make when you get hired. So you will need your passbook, the front page, the first page where all the details are given about your bank account. And you will also need a check, or a cancelled check rather. So they might ask, they might not. So do not, you know, worry, they'll tell you. You can just carry your checkbook and you're good to go. Now, one more document which is very important if you're joining Indigo, that is your demand draft. You will have to submit a demand draft worth 50,000 when you're joining Indigo. Now, other than this, they do not ask for any transfer of money, no cash, no checks, no NEFT, nothing. So please be aware and alert of any kind of scam or scammers, or, you know, pretending to be the organization. So please be aware of that. They will clearly state it in the email that they'll send you. So do not worry about that. They will give you the information, how to and where to. And the last thing that you will need, or you might need, is a police verification, or a PCC, or a police character certificate. Now this thing is very simple to get. You have to go to the police station under which you belong and request them for a character certificate, and you will get it. Now when we get our passports, it's usually police verified. Not usually, it is police verified. So technically we do not need a PCC. But sometimes you might require a PCC depending on what base you have been given. Some bases, they do ask for a PCC. So just to be on the safer side, you can just get one done and keep it. You don't have to do it right before you're going for your training. You can do it, you know, beforehand, because I think it is valid for 1 or 2 years. So if it is already done and you have it, no problem. You can just keep it. That's all you need for your training or on the day of your interview. I hope it was helpful, and like always, please do subscribe to my channel if you're new, and if you have any questions, the comment box is right there. I actually do reply to every single comment, if you have noticed, and I love to do that because I was in your place once, very confused, and it was the YouTubers who helped. So people who make videos, they always try to help. That's what I feel and that's what I try to do. And if you're going for your interview in the near future, all the very best. If you have cracked the interview and you're here to see what you need to carry when you're going, all the best to you too. You guys will love it. This is an amazing place to be. And I hope that you all do well. And I will see you guys the next time. Bye.